Ladies and gentlemen, family, friends, and loved ones of the graduating class of 2022, please turn your attention to the center aisle. The Academy of Art University graduation ceremony is about to begin. And now, the 2022 graduates. Please welcome Academy of Art University faculty members. And here they come right down the center aisle. Thank you. I'd also like to take this moment to acknowledge President Stevens, the department directors, and distinguished guests who are also up here on the stage with the faculty. Will everyone please be seated? Before we continue, I would just like to ask that everyone please turn off your cell phones and remain seated for the duration of the ceremony. Thank you. Academy graduate candidates, guests, and friends of the Academy, on behalf of the Academy Board of Directors, President Elisa Stevens, Vice President, Department Directors, faculty, and staff, I'd like to welcome you today to the Spring 2022 Commencement Exercises of Academy of Art University, San Francisco. We'll begin with a look at our 2022 graduates.
That's what you are.
Unforgettable, though near or far.
Like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been more
unforgettable in every way.
And forevermore,
and forevermore,
that's how you'll stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too. Thinks that I am unforgettable too.
That was fun. We'd like to thank all the graduates who submitted their starring video moments. Our invocation today is offered by the Reverend Monsignor Harry G. Schlitt, retired Vice General for the Archdiocese of San Francisco.
Thank you, Marvin. It's not Vice General, however. That would be a promotion for me. Vicar is bigger, is better than vice. I am deeply grateful to the Academy for inviting me here a number of years to do the invocation and the benediction. And I tried to figure out to do something a little different today, and I realized what the difference is in a graduation ceremony at a liberal arts school and one at the Academy of Art University. You know, it's hard to capture history and culture and language and all of those things, but in art, it's timeless. And what you do and your work and what you say is an example. We're going to see some samples of the work. And it's so much easier to feel the imagination and the pulse and the color and the sound and the work that has gone into something that is so visual before us. And I think it has to do with example. You know, I'd rather see a sermon than hear one any day. I'd rather one would walk with me than merely show the way. The eye's a better pupil and more willing than the ear. Counsel can be confusing, but example's always clear. And best of all, the teachers are those who live their deeds. For to see good put into action is what everybody needs. To see good put into action is what everybody needs. The great example of your work on display throughout the world is a testament to your graduating in the timeless world of art. Amen.
Thank you, Monsignor, and I apologize for making you head of vice. And now the president of Academy of Art University, Elisa Stevens.
Good morning. Oh my, what a moment. We're all together again, in one place, live. To the graduating class of 2022, this is the first day of your new lives as professional artists and designers. It is my privilege to be the first to congratulate you. Thousands of guests and supporters are here to honor your achievement. They're the people who have helped you to this day with their encouragement, their love, and their care. They'll tell you that this is your day, and it is, but really, it is their day too, their reward for all that they have done for you. I think that they deserve a big collective expression of your heartfelt thanks to parents, spouses, friends. This is Diploma Day, and today we enshrine your achievement on a piece of paper as we award it to you one by one in front of your peers, parents, and friends. But the fact is, very few people can understand what this piece of paper really represents. This piece of paper represents your considerable achievements. This paper represents countless hours worked to gain a tangible skill set that you can use in your careers. It represents an understanding of the fundamental rules of art and design. It represents rigorous attention to production and craft. For those who don't understand all that went into earning this degree, you have something of far greater value than a piece of paper, something you made all by yourself. I'm talking, of course, about your portfolio. That's the true measure of all you have done at the Academy of Art University. All that you have learned, and yes, all that you have suffered. Your portfolio is what makes you special. People outside the arts may not understand, but arts education isn't like other kinds of education, especially at the high level you have achieved. It's part apprenticeship, part trial by fire. It's learning tradition and technique through imitation and repetition. It's mastering your craft. It's about defying the ordinary and creating the extraordinary. For artists, as you know, all that really matters is the work. That's why your work, virtually everything you've created while you've been here, has been put up on an easel, or the wall, or the screen, or the runway, or the stage, put on display for your instructors and peers to respond to and critique and analyze and judge. That's how you have suffered. But as you'll discover, it was worth it. From this tough love, you have learned both your craft and the courage to pursue it. You have learned to listen, accept, change, and move forward. You have grown as artists and designers. It may not have seemed like it at the time, but these critiques of your work are a gift, pure and simple, from people who have put their hearts and souls into helping you develop and flourish as artists. They ask no thanks, but I think they deserve some anyway. And of course, I'm talking about your instructors at the Academy of Art University. And rather than asking them to stand and be recognized, let's all of us stand to honor these passionate, dedicated instructors, your mentors. Graduating class, please stand and rise, and let's give a round of applause to the instructors on this stage. Thank you. You may be seated. With degree and portfolio in hand, you are now professional artists and designers, but I won't say that you are finished artists. For most, mastering a craft is a lifelong pursuit, and if you're lucky, you never will be finished. The beauty of the career you've chosen, or more likely the one that's chosen you, is that you will keep constantly evolving. You are never finished learning, working, and growing. Artists, as creative people, need each other. They inspire each other. And in the best sense, they irritate each other. They make each other better. And together, they rise to new heights and open new frontiers in their fields. That's our wish and our hope for every member of the community that makes up the Academy of Art University family. And although we say farewell today, we are not saying goodbye. Starting this week, we are showcasing many of your talents to top firms and internationally known brands at the Academy's annual spring show event, both in person through July and virtually through the entire year. This showcase is a phenomenal way to connect industry and network with your fellow students and alumni. And I invite you all to attend our current spring show, which began yesterday and runs through July 31st at the Academy of Art College University Cannery location. As the newest member of our Alumni Association, you are all official lifetime members of our community. And we welcome you to join alumni events held around the world. And these events provide you the opportunity to network with fellow artists, designers, and industry leaders, and to learn new techniques, skills, and trends in your various fields. With this beginning, this commencement of everything you have equipped yourself to do, it's time to get out of here and do it. There is no better time to bring your artistry, your skills, and your expertise to the world of art and design. The world is hungry for creativity and craft, and you will feed that hunger And when this happens, success happens. So congratulations, class of 2022.
Now we'd like to show you some of our outstanding students' work from this past year. The Doctorate of Humane Letters is the highest degree conferred by this university. This year, we're honoring an exceptional individual who has enriched our community, enriched the world of art and design, and enriched the world in which we live. Today, we honor Richard Thomas Jennings. He is a creative leader and a visual storyteller with extensive experience in graphic design and development for multiple mediums. Richard was born in Seoul, Korea, adopted from an orphanage at 2 years old, an early age to learn the meaning of gratitude. Growing up as a child in Hawaii, Richard embraced the creative bug and would create gifts and handmade cards for everyone's birthday. However, he was raised to believe that art was not a proper profession, rather just a hobby. Encouraged by his parents to pursue a practical career, Richard embarked on a pre-med degree, but was so unhappy and lost that he withdrew. One evening, a good friend encouraged him to attend Academy of Art University, and she even filled out the application for him so he wouldn't have any excuse. That moment changed his life forever. And yes, they are still friends. Starting in illustration, Richard was still not completely content when his college advisor suggested that he take a course in graphic design. He instantly fell in love. And the rest is BFA and MFA history. Richard is currently the Senior Vice President for Design and Production for HBO and HBO Max, under the newly formed Warner Brothers Discovery. Let's take a look at some of Richard Jennings' stellar work.
Designing for HBO Max, I understand what that journey is to get to that end result. And I'm able to creatively guide the design stuff, the creative stuff. You know, that was a learning lesson too for me, was that to give up the hands-on part of it. But this is also why I felt it was important to go back and do my master's work in graphic design at the Academy of Art, because I didn't want to lose that ability. So if I had to design today, I absolutely could design. And that to me is important. But what I find is I find it more fulfilling to watch other people discover that process now and to help guide them through that creative process. That to me is what's, you know, my job as a creative leader is not to tell someone what to do. It is to allow that designer to talk about what they're doing and to help mold them or lead them in the way for that solution to be solid. You know, what I always find as a problem is when someone says, oh, I just like this color, or I just like this typeface. I'm like, but why? What does that have to do with the story? And that, just asking those questions of someone, allows them to really think about the meaning, because I think everything you do has to have meaning. It can't just be because people are going to look at that and they will feel that meaning when you put that much thought into what you're doing.
Richard Jennings, please rise to receive the degree of Doctorate of Humane Letters.
Richard Jennings, we are profoundly moved by your contribution to the world of art and design. Mr. Jennings, by virtue of the authority granted by the Charter to the Academy of Art University from the State of California, and by the powers vested in me by the Governing Board, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereunto, and thank you for your contribution to the arts.
Hello, everyone, and thank you to Dr. Stevens and the Academy. I am completely humbled, honored, and filled with an immense sense of gratitude. I never dreamt that this is where I would be standing one day. It proves that if you live your life with passion, it leads you to the most unexpected places. As a kid, my mother said to me, if you make decisions based on money, you will never truly be happy. But if you make decisions based on passion and happiness, then the rewards will be bountiful. I am not here today to tell you that my life has been easy, because it has not. But I can say that those challenging moments have defined me. It is how you leverage those lessons you've learned that matters. True growth and opportunity happen in tough times. I would like to share with you 7 things I have learned over the years. 1, as creatives, our responsibility is to visualize solutions for others. We are all unique, and so is each creative problem. Your point of view and shared experiences in life are an important part of discovering the solution. At the core of our responsibility, we must understand human behavior and engagement because you are visual storytellers. 2, you know what it is to be inspired because you live it every day, inside and out. And you know great ideas come from everywhere. We are enthusiastic, empathetic, and inspiring problem solvers. So you must live in the power of possibilities. 3, always focus on the goal. The journey is seldom from point A to B. You may often travel to C and D, but keep your eye on the goal of getting back to B. It doesn't matter how you get there, as long as you do. Embrace the journey of discovery. Remember, you are never alone. Collaboration drives the work. The collective will always make it better. And know your ability to work together is going to be your greatest strength. 4, commit to excellence because that is the standard. The details matter. Respect how you show up, and in turn, you will be respected. 5, time is of the essence. Make every second count. There is a constant pressure today in being connected, professionally, socially, and culturally. These are real factors that impact our productivity. There needs to be a greater balance with shutting off, or at least shutting down. So make balance your focus. 6, live in relevance. Don't become numb to life around you. That means personally and professionally. If it means take another academic course, do it. If it means that you alter the same daily routine in some way, do it. I promise you that you will always remain aware of your experiences because you have got to continue to grow. 7, lastly, the greatest gift is the act of giving back. Find a way to share your creative ability in service of others, even if it is sharing your story, mentorship, or even pro bono work. Now, I ask that you take a second with me, look around, and breathe in this sublime moment. Make it unforgettable, because you've earned it. I leave you with this one thought. We are all unique. Everyone's path is different. And because of that, it is impossible to compare yourself with another. It will only lead to disappointment. So I implore you to embrace your individuality. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for allowing me to be a part of your momentous achievement today.
Each year, the Academy is proud to recognize outstanding alumni for their contribution to art and design. The Distinguished Alumni Award is awarded to these alumni for their leadership, integrity, success, and significant commitment to creative excellence and innovation. Today, we honor Kathleen Valkacek, director of the School of Architecture and Design here at the Academy. Before earning her MFA at the Academy of Art University, Katie, as she is known to her Academy colleagues and students, received her BA in art history at UC Santa Cruz. It was here, through an undergraduate internship and an after-school program for children, that she first discovered her passion for art education. After graduating from the Academy of Art in 2006, Katie worked with several design firms in San Francisco, including Angela Free Design and Bakken, Gilliam, and Kroger Architects. Katie went on to become a design consultant, working with various companies in the Bay Area, where she provided comprehensive services from design concept to project management. She began teaching with the Academy as an adjunct professor in 2011, and in 2017, she assumed the directorship of the School of Interior Architecture and Design. Katie is grateful for her opportunity to share her love for design, her knowledge, and her experience with her students and with her colleagues. And she's proud to share this morning's stage with her nominee for our MFA valedictorian. So let's meet our honoree, Kathleen Valkacek, Interior Architecture and Design, MFA 2006.
Before I began teaching as an adjunct instructor at the Academy, I worked for several design firms in the Bay Area, ranging from large to small. I did end-to-end design on high-end residential, commercial, and hospitality projects, which means I got practical experience all the way from the conceptual design phase of the project to the finished construction. One of my favorite parts was being able to work with the many different trades. And I really enjoyed the collaborative environment of a project site. I learned a lot, which I was so excited to bring back to the Academy and share with the new generation of students and designers. When I started teaching for the Academy, I discovered how rewarding it could be to pass on this knowledge and learn more about my craft through teaching it to others. More recently, as the director of the School of Interior Architecture and Design, I've become more passionate about inclusive design. I'm especially proud of our group of IED students who worked on the Five Keys Home Free project with the help of their instructors and the women that they were designing for. They transformed a 6-unit rundown apartment into transitional housing for recently incarcerated survivors of domestic abuse. I was in awe watching the students pull together these beautiful, welcoming spaces for these women, working with them, listening to them, taking notes, and creating environments for them to now flourish in as they begin the next chapter of their lives. Their dedication and great work is one of the reasons why I love being an educator, a designer, and part of the Academy community.
It's easy to see why we are so proud of our alumni. Kathleen Valkacek, please rise to receive your award. Congratulations on your contribution to art and design. The Graduate Valedictorian Award is given to this year's graduate student with the highest academic achievement. Please welcome Master of Arts Valedictorian Eleanor Lyon, Interior Architecture and Design.
Good morning. I'm honored to represent the classes of 2021 and 2022. On a summer day almost 10 years ago, my husband unexpectedly died on a backpacking trip. One day, I'm shuttling our four kids to swim practice, and the next, I'm planning their father's funeral. They were 12, 9, 7, and 4 years old. When he was buried, I felt like many of our plans and dreams were buried along with him, including my hope to go to art school someday soon. Shortly after, a psychologist told me I was an optimist, which, to be honest, felt a little offensive. Did he really think I was a glass half full sort of person? How could I be, given that the life I loved was suddenly snatched from me? Sure, optimism is about hoping for the best in all things, he said. But optimism is also the capacity to imagine possibilities. Whether or not you think you're an optimist, I'm here to tell you that you are. You're all here today because of your capacity to imagine the possibilities, despite whatever obstacles and setbacks have been thrown your way. We are an art school, which means that many majors rely on the three-dimensional realm: canvas, paint, metal, fabrics, in essence, materials. Materials that seem to have been snatched from us and buried in the virtual world. How is it possible that so many of the interior design graduates have never created a material board out of actual real-life materials? Yet here we are, still dreaming big, as evidenced by yet another mind-blowing spring show. You have imagined the possibilities and made them an incredibly beautiful reality. For our instructors, these past 2 years must have felt like riding a bicycle while trying to build it, whether transitioning from on-site to online or supporting our mental well-being while trying to support your own. We are deeply grateful for all you've done. While it's impossible for me to talk about every instructor who has taught us with grace and wisdom, here are three examples whose optimism carried us through. Tom Collum in Studio One taught us how to open our eyes, our hearts, and our minds to the possibilities of the world around us. Scott Kress in Studio 2 taught us how to discover the possibilities within ourselves. You can't be the best at everything, he told us, but you are the best in at least one thing. How are you going to share that? And closing out our program was Katie Valkacek in Studio 3, who strengthened our self-confidence while showing us that collaboration resulted in more innovative possibilities. Thank you to all our instructors for all the brands of optimism you've instilled in us. In the words of the mystic Thomas Merton, you do not need to know precisely what is happening or exactly where it is all going. What you need is to recognize the possibilities and challenges offered by the present moment and to embrace them with courage, faith, and hope. Graduates, now more than ever, the world needs your courage, your faith, your hope, and your unique brand of optimism. Keep imagining the possibilities and keep making them a beautiful reality. Congratulations.
And now the moment you've all been waiting for. Will the candidates for the Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts please stand? President Stevens, on behalf of the Board of Directors, Department Directors, and Faculty, it is my pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts in the field of Fine and Applied Arts.
By virtue of the authority granted by the Charter of the Academy of Art University from the State of California, and the powers vested in me by the Governing Board, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Masters of Arts and Masters of Fine Arts, certified by your faculty, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereunto, and declare that you are now ready to practice on an advanced level your chosen field in the fine and applied arts.
You may be seated. I want to remind you that a professional photograph of each graduate will be taken during the ceremony. And also of note, as I announce each school, there will be a music cue, and that music cue was produced by students here at the Academy of Art School of Music Production and Sound Design. Academy of Art University Chief Academic Officer Eileen Everett will now present the degrees, and we will begin with our graduate valedictorian, Eleanor Lyon. We'll proceed with the Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts in Visual Development. Lindsay McLean. I'll give it to you then. Michelle O'Neill. You, Michelle? Soreen Kim. Rosa Mendez Tejada. Luiselle Marceline. Julian Acevedo. Shamil McKay. Monica Sabrina Galadriel Bedford. Hilda Flores. Helga Scheel. Mana Srisutayanan. Kantisa Prasarchai. Fang Chun Jung. Daniel Jackson. Pingxuan Chao. Christopher Hayes. Lawrence Davis. And those were our graduates in fine arts and visual development. Next, we'll have the students from the Master of Art, Master of Fine Arts in Animation and Visual Effects. Jamar Shaw. Junjie Shu. Xinpai Han. Heather Fries. Sierra Gunwagen. Raphael Duffy. Matthew Higgins. Simon Williams. Ashley Pulliam. Josiah Sweeney. Christian Lorraine. Michelle Gobi Strachan. Laura Vitalina. Ti Ying Zhao. Hannah Rogers, Aya Sylvie Yao, Kevin Shi, Tony Kim, Chi Chie Chun, Pei Yuan Hu, Chun Lang Yu. Is that it? Same one? Okay. Tei Wei Chung, Yi Ying Lin, Yi Ran Gu, Shu Qi Jin, He Xin Wu, Maria Jesus Mayo Mingo, Charlene Rosario, Nora Beatrice Girao Arroyo, Wilma Miranda, Samantha Hemanson, Shivani Reddy Tumala, Dave Choi, Dana Wee, Sakura Hoshi, Kristen Joy Smolinski, Ali Cornett, Kalpak Sunil Deshmukh, Chenyu Xiong, Rakshith Raja Shekhar, Halimat Folake Usman, Bautian Tran, thank you, Sebastian Saruti, Fong Yip Lee, Delroy Edwards, Bless Gomez, Shannon Casto, Brian Gable, Drake Thornton, Jacqueline Murphy, Lucky Patrick Enam, Paul Hufnagel, Pranav Nitin Juvakar, Yu Chen Chung, Shi En Lo, Chun Yen Chun, Natsuko Beppu, Dongkyun Lee, Kat Soriano, Umar Ahmad Yusuf, Amanda Price, Shanwut Lokajorn, Sivagorn Krivit, and Sparkle Sap. And those are our graduates with a Master of Fine Arts in Animation and Visual Effects. Now the Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts in Game Development. Yiying Wang, Yunhao Gai. Michelle Gao. Leticia Longbons. Paula Kunada. Fan Yang. Shi Zhong Luo. Patrick Pepito. Ge Fang. Yunzi Wang. Jin Park. Emma Marie Graziella Landolfini. Sydney Stewart. Yunlin Gao. Fengyang Zeng. Robert Grasso. And Swati Hemant Hathi. And those are our graduates in game development. Now the Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts in Landscape Architecture. Yin Zhang. Yi Cheng Fang. And those are our graduates in architecture, landscape architecture. We will now switch sides. We'll continue by honoring the graduates with a Master of Fine Arts and Master of Arts in Illustration. Sopi Lee Kin. Charlena Karim. Wen Li Cheng. Brianna Sayikes. Chunji Jin. Liang Gao Yue Sun. Xin Yi Shun. Wen Yen Chun. Erica McGee. And those are our graduates with a master's in illustration. Now the Master of Fine Arts and Master of Arts in Interior Architecture and Design. Allison Gallegos. Jennifer Punjani. Faith Chapman. Joan Mundell. Manar Munawar. Panasi Sinkakam. Prem Tipaporn. Ava Napaporn. Jesse Huang. Imelda Edita Ella Edjang. Jamal Abdelhadi. Courtney Smith. Arlene Solomon. Li Ying Lu. Wei Yi Wan. Peng Guo. Adrian Thompson. Marcel Mohammed Helmi. Asiye Syed Payadari. Palak Jignishbai Gadhia. Sudamini Suresh Patil. Aishwarya Sunil Saraf. Sri Lalita Mahankali. Ariana Ramzian. Paige Starks. Camila Suisun Lecomte. Jocelyn Quiros Navarrete. Ayushi Ginger. Tian Dao Tui. Saloni Kapoor. Soumya Jain. Celia Changotia. Disha Nagarkar. Rama Sarvani Nuvala. Madison Crum. Kelly Campos. Amy Hammond. Li Fu Chiao. Tianze Wang. And those represent our graduates with the Master of Fine Arts in Interior Architecture and Design. And now, ladies and gentlemen, our next category is the Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts in Jewelry and Metal Arts. Himanshi Dixit. Haize Lee. And those were our graduates in the Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts in Jewelry and Metal Arts. The Master of Fine Arts in Acting. Very interesting. Blake Edward Weaver. Raykovsky. Mehran Yeshivas. Caleb Stewart. And Brandy Seville. And those are our graduates in acting. Are we doing jewelry today? There is jewelry. This is all of advertising. Okay. Now we'll present the candidates for Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts in Advertising. Katie Hajar. Reina Bakshi, Suri Fun, Joseph Christian Villan Oliveras, Vivo, Kriti Jogal, Brianna Kilgore, Tyler John Aguilera, Laksamana Riadi, Cesar Garcia, Concia Tranquilo. Oh, go that. And those are our candidates in advertising. Now we'll move on to the category of Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts in Industrial Design. Laura Melissa Arayave Remolina. Vishnavi Narayanan Dinesh. Ayushi Dharmesh Shah. Heidi Liao. Alana Miller. Ian Powell. Zhu Huai Wang. Shanghan Li. Baijia Li. Altino Alexandre Cordero Neto. Munan Zhang. And those are our candidates in industrial design. And finally, our final category, the Master of Arts and Master of Fine Arts in Music Production and Sound Design for Visual Media. Alan K. Murray II, Han Wen Jiang, Leah Ma, Thomas Asko, Morve Noor Tokar, Ray Shin Lee, Jialin Yang, and Mengting Liu. Ah, Sirui Huang. There you are. How about a special round of applause for these graduates, because they're the ones who created the sound cues that we've been having. Will all the new Master of Arts, Master of Fine Arts degree recipients please stand? Graduates, congratulations. You may move your tassels to the left. And please be seated. Monsignor Schlitt will now close the commencement exercises with the benediction. And after that, we will ask you to rise and observe the recessional led by Chief Academic Officer Eileen Everett.
There are many things that I don't know, and one of them is how this man pronounces your names every year. Let's give Marvin a big hand. I just finished a second book called I Don't Know. And on the cover of that book is a little child, a little baby that I just baptized. And she's looking up in my eyes, and I'm saying to myself, I'll never know. This little girl could one day be the president of the United States. Or she could discover the cure for cancer, or go to the moon, or so many different things. And this happens to us. As we go along in our careers, we suddenly discover there are people in our lives that we don't really know whatever happens to them. Just the person sitting next to you graduating today, in 10 years, will you know where they are, who they are, why they're there? I used to hold a spiritual class in a federal penitentiary, and every Saturday morning I'd go there and the guard would be there and he said, who are you? Every Saturday morning, I'm Father Harry. Well, why are you here? I'm here because I'm teaching a class in spirituality. Really? And where are you going? I'm going to cell block C. Every Saturday, these guys ask me the same questions. And it's only these many years later, when occasions like this happen, where you're graduating, moving on, a new degree, a new perspective, that it's worthwhile with your family and friends to say, who am I? Why am I here? Where am I going? May God guide all of you to happiness and worthwhile so you can give example to the many people that you will influence by your art. And for your family and friends, have a great day of celebration. Amen.
Now I will ask that you all rise one more time, and please remain standing till the end of the recessional after the Chief Academic Officer Everett, the directors, faculty, and distinguished guests have exited the auditorium.